Namaste to everyone. In the first lesson, we are going to learn what is anthropology, its meaning and scope and divisions in the anthropology, or we can call them as sub-divisions of anthropology. The term anthropology is from the Greek anthropos, it means human being, and logos, discourse or the study, and was first used in 1501 by German philosopher Magnus Hunt. Starting the study of Magnus Hunt, Anthropologium in 1501, and Galgios Capreas, another anthropologist who has written Anthropologia in 1533, it may be seen that both these people started claiming that they are the first people who coined the word anthropology. But the competition among them have first promoted as an academic discipline. Magnus Hunt's article was first show that the comprehensive study of humankind with a focus on the unity of body and soul predates the Renaissance and has its roots in late antiquity and the Middle Age. Whereas Capra's Anthropologia is more focused on the study of humankind in the sense of mapping and assessing the various facets of human beings and their existence. These are the two differences in their studies between Magnus Hunt and Capra's studies. So based on the time period and the subject matter which they have published in anthropology, Magnus Hunt, the German philosopher, physician and theologian, Hunt coined the term anthropology and have been mentioned as a founder of anthropology since they used the term in the 16th century. Quite literally, anthropology is the study of humanity. It is the study of everything and anything that makes us human. From cultures to language to material remains and human evolution, anthropologists examine every dimension of humanity as by asking compelling different questions. Now let us define anthropology in a simple way. Now we can say anthropology is the study of science of mankind or humanity. In simple definition of anthropology, we can say that anthropology is the study of science of humanity as a whole. Now look into the aspects of this simple definition. Anthropology is the study or science of humanity as a whole. That means, you know, anthropology is studies humanity as a whole. That means, you know, from the origin of the man, that is from primate to present day, human population we are studying. That is one of the definition. Anthropology is a broad scientific discipline dedicated to the comparative study of humans as a group from its first appearance on earth to its present stage of development. This definition, we can observe that anthropology is a broad scientific discipline is one. That means, you know, it cut across all the disciplines. There is no limit for this subject. We can say anthropology as a mother of all disciplines. If we look into the aspects of the different disciplines, anthropology goes across all the disciplines and it compared to a study of humans as groups. This is very important. That means, you know, it is not only study community as a whole, but it studies the groups. That means, you know, people who are in different countries and different states, different districts, different villages that these anthropology studies, and it compares from one group to another and one culture to another culture, how they differ each other and how they unique together. That is very important aspects of anthropology. From its first appearance on earth to its present stage of development is a very important aspect. That means, you know, it covers the evolutionary aspects, especially the evolutionary principles such as mutation, genetic drift, migration, isolation, parallelism and covering gene, adaptation, radiation, irreversibility of extinction is some of the aspects which we will be covering in this, and also the fossil remains and primate evolutionary changes, how a man has developed. That is very important subject matter which we will be covering, and we will be knowing evolutionary how development took place, both biological evolution and also the cultural evolution. Along with the biological evolution, how the cultural evolution also changed over a period of time is the study of man, that is anthropology. Anthropology, the World Book Encyclopedia mentions that anthropology analyzes the products of social groups, that is material objects such as stools, cloths, house, etc., and not material creations such as beliefs, values, practices and institutions. It is really an interesting subject to know that from this definition that anthropology analyzes the products of social groups, that means in a human populations and a society, what are the objectives they produce? That is, you know, material objectives, first it says, that is tools, cloths, houses, etc. That means, you know, from stone and access to present day technology, how it has been developed by various groups and how it has been developed over a period of time. The invention of fire, the invention of the wheel, and the creation of the iron metal, all these things should be considered. Present day computer and software technology, all these will be studied by anthropologists. Another aspect is non-material creation. It is a very important subject matter of anthropology, that is how the belief system has developed over a period of time, the values of human populations and the practices, different practices, especially the religious practices and family and as a system, how it has been developed and how they are practicing as kinship system, and that is very important. And development of languages, how over a period of time the language has been developed, all these things will be discussed in this aspect. Apart from this, the institutional development, that is what we have told, the family, the system of family, and the development of the marriage system and the caste system is also one of the important one. Then institutions of different categories is also studied in this field of anthropology. Further, we can say that anthropology focuses on the origin of man, the evolutionary development of humans, the human physical, biochemical and cultural variations, and the material positions and cultural heritages of humans. This is very important aspects of anthropological studies. Howard and Don Hattis mentions that anthropology ultimate goal is to develop an integrated picture of humankind. That is a goal that encompasses an almost infinite number of questions about all aspects of our existence. Here, it is to be understood that the universe of anthropology is very vast, and a number of questions will be arising again and again. Now we will look into some of them, or what we are going to ask and what we are going to know. We ask, for example, what makes us human? Why do some groups of people tend to be tall and lanky? It is a very important one. Some people are tall, some people are stature is less. For example, you take the China, the people are short. Whereas in European people, they are very tall. The African people are very tall. So these are the some of the things which will be getting into the minds of the students and scholars. Why do some groups of people practice agriculture while others hunt for living? This is another important question to be answered by anthropology. Why some groups of people practice agriculture? Some societies belong to agrarian societies. They practice agriculture, whereas other societies, developed countries and developed societies, they will go for industrialization and urbanization, urban expansion of the impacts, how they have been developed, and over a period of time, how they have given up the agriculture and became industrialists. Another anthropologists are interested in all things of humans. That is, you know, almost all things, what it makes as a human, what they create, what they invent, invention, all are the aspects of study of anthropology. The unique characteristics of anthropology, now we will be discussing. The first one is, anthropology is a holistic, that is, studying one aspect of the ways of life, a group of people, by relating it to other complex related aspects of life. Now, in depth, we will go and have what it states as holistic. The distinguishing feature of the discipline of anthropology is its holistic approach to the study of human groups. Anthropological holism evidenced in a number of important ways. First, the anthropological approach involves both biological and structural aspects of humanity. That is, anthropologists are interested in people's genetics, endowment, as well as what people acquire from their socio-cultural environment after birth. The second one is, anthropology has the deepest possible time frame, starting with the earliest beginning of humans several million years ago, right up to the present. Anthropology is holistic to the extent that it studies all varieties of people wherever they may be found. That is, anthropology, global perspective, considers the life of East African pastoralists, Polynesian farmers, and Japanese business people, all to be equally legitimate subjects of anthropological studies. So it is a vast subject matter that is deals with the anthropology. Another important uniqueness of anthropology is, anthropology is relativistic. That is, anthropology tries to study and explain a certain belief, practice, or institution of a group of people in its own context. It does not make value judgment. That is, declaring that this belief or practice is good or that is bad. This is a really unique characteristics of the anthropology scholars. That means, you know, they study and they present which is good or which is bread as it is. Important aspects of anthropology is, anthropology is a comparative in nature. Anthropology studies certain aspects of the culture of a group of people by comparing it across societies and different times, that is, the present with the past, the modern with the traditional, etc. From this you can able to understand that anthropology studies the cultures of different groups of people, and it compares with one group to another and shares the data from one group to another group. So exchange of the information is very important of aspects of anthropology. How the past 20 years back, how it was, and now how they are growing, how they are developing, how they are changing, and how they are adapting to the new environment and new policies of government, and over a period of time how they will be changing, that is also observed by the anthropologists. The important characteristics of anthropology is emphasizing on insider's view, that is, anthropologist focuses on how the people themselves understand about their world, how a particular group of people explains about the world, etc. This is what anthropologists call emic perspectives. See here, it is very important subject matter of anthropology that anthropologist as a research investigator joins with the people and stays with them for a number of months and number of years, understand the particular culture and writes a dissertation or a thesis. That is, you know, he becomes a member of that society, that is called as emic perception. Upon people's perception he presents. It is not a biased study. That is a unique characteristics of the anthropologist. No subject or no discipline have this type of research method to present the whole culture of the society, that is emic perception, that is the unique characteristic of anthropology. Another distinguished mark of anthropology is it focuses on small scale societies or community. The kinds of social groups or communities anthropologists study, whether they are in traditional or modern world, are usually small scale in their social organization, economic and political structure, and tend to be homogeneous in their overall character. This is very important distinguished character of anthropology, that anthropology studies the small groups and smaller societies which are interior in their living. That means, you know, as a society they will study, they will go into the interior places, study the tribal societies or village communities. That is what here anthropologists are more focused to study the smaller groups, smaller communities, whether they are living in remote areas or urban areas, it doesn't matter. And they present the holistic nature of that community or that tribe or that caste. That is a unique characteristics of the anthropology, the social organization, economic and political structure they will present. Another important aspect of anthropology is its research methodology. The hallmark of anthropology are qualitative research methods such as extended fieldwork, focus group discussion, participant observation, in-depth and key informant interviews. Although these methods are now practiced in the other behavioral sciences as well, but anthropologically they are different from other Now I wanted to explain here about research methodology, as though we have a separate unit of study, research methodology, a separate paper we will be dealing. But here I would like to mention briefly about the research methods. Here anthropological backbone is a prolonged period of field work, that a research scholar goes to the field and stays months together and years together, collects the data and analyzes the data and submits the report. The researcher participates in the groups and also goes to the focus group discussions and find out the real factors and real problems, real issues and their culture, way of life from that focus group. That is very important. Apart from that, participant observation, in-depth key informants and interviews will be conducted. That is, you know, the prolonged period of stay, they will, in the period of stay, they will go for structured and unstructured questionnaires they will be using for collection of the data, which is very important for them. In-depth and key informative interviews, that is important in this anthropological studies. The questions like, how did we come to human and who are our ancestors? Why do people look and act so differently throughout the world? What do we all have in common? How have we changed culturally and biologically over a period of time? What factors influence diverse human beliefs and behavior throughout the world? So, if you look into these questions, and we will be getting for all these questions answer from anthropological subject only by reading. The ancestors, human development, and how people have looked differently, and how common we are all living, and culturally and biologically how we differ each other, and diverse human beliefs and behavior all over the world, and different cultures which we are having all over the world, are all the questions which were raised by the many of the students, and we will be getting answer for all these if you study anthropology. We can observe that these questions are very broad questions. Indeed, anthropology is an expansive field of study. It is comprised of four fields. So, based on the subject matter, we can divide the anthropology into four fields, such as cultural anthropology, archaeology, biological or physical anthropology, and linguistic anthropology. Then, we can also add applied anthropology, which is also presently became very popular subfield of anthropology. Together, all these four subfields provide a multifaceted picture of human condition. Applied anthropology, which I have mentioned you now, is another area of specialization within or between the anthropological subfields. It aims to solve specific practical problems in collaboration with the governmental, non-profit and community organizations, as well as business and corporations. The subject matter of anthropology further can be classified into different specializations. In biological anthropology, which is also called as physical anthropology, which includes forensic anthropology, paleoanthropology, paleontology, paleobotany, medical anthropology, primatology, osteology, and neuroanthropology. Cultural anthropology, also called as social anthropology, includes anthropology of art, anthropology of law, anthropology of media, anthropology of religion, applied anthropology, cross-cultural studies, cyber anthropology, developmental anthropology, dual inheritance theory, environmental anthropology, economic anthropology, ecological anthropology, ethnography, ethnomusicology, feminist anthropology, human behavior ecology, medical anthropology, psychology anthropology, political anthropology, public anthropology, symbolic anthropology, urban anthropology, and visual anthropology. Linguistic anthropology includes synchronic linguistics or descriptive linguistics, diachronic linguistics or historical linguistics, the ethnolinguistics and sociolinguistics. Archaeology includes experimental archaeology, historical archaeology, public archaeology, and geoarchaeology. Anthropology as a human science, its basic concern are what defines Homo sapiens, who are the ancestors of modern Homo sapiens, what are humans, physical and cultural traits, which is very important for the students to understand how culturally, physically, human variations in different aspects of populations, and how do humans behave from one country or one culture to another culture. Why are the variations and differences among different groups of humans? It is culturally different how they are and how they are unique, or different aspects of culture will be studied or answered by studying anthropology subject. How has the evolutionary past of Homo sapiens influenced its social organization and culture? That means, you know, how evolutionary past, that is in evolution of human beings, and how culture along with the society has developed, social organization has developed, the communities has been developed, and political system, social organization, economy, religion, all these things which will be studied in anthropology. The scope and subject matter of anthropology is very broad. It is a human science. The breadth and depth of anthropology is immense. There are no time and space left as far as a man exists. In other words, the temporal dimensions covers the past, present, and the future. Overall, we can say, in terms of spatial dimension, anthropology studies from Arctic to desert, from megapolis to hunting-gathering areas. The discipline covers all aspects of human ways of life, experience, and existence as humans live in a social group. Anthropology as a science of human studies, it covers and studies almost all the societies in the world which are existing. It studies food-gathering societies, food-gathering hunting societies, fishing societies, horticultural societies, artisan communities, pastoral communities, shifting and cultivation societies, nomadic tribes, agricultural societies, industrial and urban exposure societies, tribal refugees, and nexal and intergent affected tribes and societies. It also studies the industrial societies and information societies, present day problems which are facing with the nexalites and intrusion groups also it studies. Now I wanted to share my knowledge and experience with the human societies in India, where I have extensively worked among the different societies having different economy and cultures. Now let us look into the some of the human populations and their way of life and their living conditions. Anthropologist studies the people who are inhabiting in the remote areas. The Chollaicans or the cave dwellers or from Kerala is the best example. The Korva, who is having hunting as a major substance of economy. The Jarvas of Andaman Islands have fishing and hunting as their main substance of economy. You can see here the Kutia Konda of Orissa having the Podu lands. Backside you can see slash and burn as a substance of economy. Their culture is totally different from others. Here is an artisan community, the Asur tribes of Jharkhand, who are the first inventor of the iron, is one of the best examples of the human societies which has given us the iron implements. The pastoral tribes, the Toras, is another best example, who is having milk and milk products, main substance of economy. They have the polyandry once, now they have forgotten slowly over a period of time. Bariya, a vulnerable tribal group inhabiting in Orissa, Madhya Pradesh and Jharkhand regions, is moving from one place to another place in search of food. This is the most vulnerable population. The anthropology studies these human societies. The next important society is the horticultural societies. The best example is the Kotas of Nilgiri Hills. Still, they are practicing horticulture as their main substance of economy. Another important one, subject of study, is the peasant communities. Once the Lanchasaura was food gatherers and hunters. Now they became settled agriculture, and the transformation of these societies can be studied here. The Baiga of Central India is one of the important study that we can make among the peasant communities. How traditionalism change and continuity among these societies continuing. Abus Maria is one of the most important tribal society inhabiting Jharkhand Bastar region, who is more prone for Naxalites. This society is suffering since last 3 decades with the impact of Naxalites. Another important society is Maram Naga of Nagaland, where the insurgent groups and other problems they are facing for their survival. Bichia is another important society who has affected with the industrialization, establishment of the steel industries and excavations of bauxite and hematite metals in Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh and Bihar affected the societies in different ways. So anthropology tries to study and understand the cultures and how they can able to rehabilitate it by using the anthropological methods. So it is a vast subject matter. It covers all the aspects of human science which deal with the man, with the nature, time and space. It touches all aspects of human conditions as far as there is a relation between human beings and natural environment and man and man. Anthropology not only tries to account for the social and cultural variation in the world, but a crucial part of the anthropological project also consists in conceptualizing and understanding similarities between social systems and human relationship. As one of the foremost anthropologists of the 20th century, Claude Lévi-Strauss, has expressed anthropology as a humanity as its objects of research, but unlike the other human sciences, it tries to grasp its objects through its most diverse manifestations. In other words, anthropology studies humanity with its all aspects of existence and in its all means of differences, that is the diversity and similarity, that is commonality, where every human being lives, there is always anthropology. And the scope and how deep the subject matter is. People have misconceptions about anthropology. Many of them think that anthropology is limited to the study of primitive societies. No, it is wrong. It is not only limited to the primitive societies. It is extended to almost all the societies, from food gathering, hunting, pastoralism, fishing societies, hunting and gathering societies, nomadic societies, agricultural societies, industrial societies, and information societies. It is not only limited to the primitive societies. The next one is, anthropology only study the rural people and rural areas. No, we are not studying only the rural people, we are rural societies. Anthropologists are also studying the urban societies, urban problems and urban issues. Then anthropology are only interested in the study of far away, remote, exotic communities living in isolation from the influence of modernization. No, it is also wrong concept of thinking. No doubt that we are going to remote and interior areas for the study, but also we are going to study the modern societies. That is very important. Another important one, misconception is, anthropology wants to keep and preserve primitive, defunct cultural practices in museums, and anthropologists are advocates of defunct absolute cultures. This is also not true. No doubt that anthropologists are interested to preserve the cultural heritages, that is, human remains and how we have developed in the museums, but also we are preserving the present day cultures, and we can able to do the comparative studies, how we have evolved, how the civilization has developed over a period of time. For that, we need the past, present and future studies also. So, anthropology is not only restricted to certain areas and certain populations. It is a global study on global issues with concern with the man and environment. It touches all aspects of human conditions as far as there is a relation between human beings and natural environment and man and man. Anthropology not only tries to account for the social and cultural variation in the world, but a crucial part of the anthropological project also consists in conceptualizing and understanding similarities between social systems and human relationship. Interrelationships between different aspects of human existence. And usually, anthropologists investigate these interrelationships, taking as their point of departure and detailed study of local life in a particular society or delineated social environment. This is very important. Many of the monographs, many of the studies on caste populations and different societies are studied by anthropologists in these aspects. One may therefore say that anthropology asks large questions, while at the same time it draws its most important insights from small places. Although anthropologists have wide-ranging and frequently high specialized interests, they all share a common concern in trying to understand both connections within societies and connections between the societies. It is very important. Now, to develop the human relations and the human to nature and human to other environment, it will be concerned, and it will be society to society, how we are working together for the sustainable development or sustainable livelihood. Such focus areas of investigation and the stated aims of the discipline convey that the areas covered by anthropology is diverse and enormous. Anthropologists strive for an understanding of the biological and cultural origins and past and present, as well as the behavior patterns throughout system and material possessions. In short, anthropology aims to be diverse, describe in the broadest sense what it means to be human. From this, we can able to understand that anthropology tries its level best to understand the biological, cultural origins, past and present. It is a very important one which you can observe here. It understands the biological, that is human evolution, and present day biological conditions and health problems and issues of the human populations, and cultural origins, that means, you know, how culture has developed over a period of time, savage, barbarism and civilization, which has been classified by the anthropologists and explained to the people how we have evolved culturally, that is in comparison with the past and present, how we are and how we are going to be, also discussed in applied anthropology, that is futuristic anthropology. We can say that anthropology aims to describe the broadest sense what we mean to be humans. That is the whole essence of anthropology. That is, it gives the description of what means to be humans. In other words, we can say anthropology is mother of all disciplines. That means, you know, without anthropology, there is no discipline exist. For example, the London School of Economics first paper on teaching for the economic students is Economic Anthropology, where they will taught about the barbarian system of economy, how economy evolved over a period of time. It is to be learnt primitive stages of economy to present day of economy, that is marketing system, how it has been evolved over a period of time. Present day marketing, that is online purchasing and online delivery system, how it is going on, how it is evolved, all these things will be discussed in anthropology. Another important aspect of anthropology, I would like to inform you to the students, that a scholar or a teacher or a student, one must be interdisciplinary in nature. This is very important characteristics for anthropology student. Then only you can able to flourish. Anthropology subject borrows the techniques and methodology and also the concepts from different disciplines. Then only you can able to flourish. For example, I myself is one of the best examples for interdisciplinary research and adopting interdisciplinary methodology for my research to build up my career. The first research I have started in Andaman Islands, where I have studied the endangered aborigines and the environment of Andaman Islands. This is one of the project which I have taken up, which brought laurels to me and name and fame entire world. This subject matter includes health, nutrition, demography, culture and environment. It is an interdisciplinary research. Anthropology goes across all the disciplines and explains how human beings are. So one must be not be biased. I have borrowed the techniques and I have taken the students from different disciplines. In this, the biological anthropology, that is anthropometry, also I have studied. I wanted to inform you to the students, one must be broad-minded. You should not be narrow-minded, that is restricted to anthropology itself. Other important research work which I have taken is how the culture and civilization has evolved through ages, that is the sacred complex of Tirumala Tirupati, structure and change, how it has changed over a period of time, how it has been evolved as a great traditional god. Once it was a little tradition worshipped by the Kurumba tribe. how it has been evolved, all are discussed in this one. So it is important that anthropology takes the methods and concepts from different fields of studies. Another important research project which I have taken up was Man in Search of Man. The concept I have developed with an interdisciplinary methodology and interdisciplinary research tools used for this. Here, in this project, I have studied 75 primitive tribes, that is particularly vulnerable tribes who are living in India. That is very important aspects of my contribution to the nation and the people of India. Here, as an interdisciplinary research, I have studied the folklore, folk culture, mythology, anthropology, sociology, economic, political science, religion, health and nutrition, developmental studies, and policy planning. So, it is a vast subject matter. In every ethnographic report, I have included interdisciplinary subjects. That is why the project, which was successful, and now it is on the YouTube, every week one movie you can see from the YouTube. Anthropology borrows and starts its foundation from history of anthropology. That is very, very important. Not only prehistory, archaeology, from folk songs to folklore, we will be tracing the origin. Folk culture is very important aspect of anthropology. So, we are not only limited to study only the human population in a particular time and particular geographical area. Our universe is very wide. That is why anthropology is a popular subject in Europe, USA, Canada, and many other developed countries. They wanted to learn what we were once, now what we are, so that we can change our way of life. So, by studying the anthropology, one can able to understand how we are, how we were, now what way we have to live. That is, you know, the anthropology gives the enough knowledge, the family, marriage system and existence, how to respect your parents, how to respect your guru, how to live in the society, what are the basic things which you have to observe in a caste, in a society, and when you are with the elders, and also with the when you are working with the multinational companies or any other institutions. It is a character building. The subject builds up the character of a human being. So anthropology encompasses all the ways of life of a human being. Thank you for watching this and also learning something about anthropology. Next class, we will be looking into the cultural anthropology. Thank you.